Welcome back to another live virtual interview. I'm joined now by Hans Buwalda of LogiGear. Hans, thanks for sitting down with me today.
Yeah, you're welcome. I'm glad for that you have me.
Yeah, absolutely, of course. We were just talking beforehand, what do we want to chat about on this talk? And you mentioned same sprint automation. And I don't know what that is, and I'm sure the audience is interested in learning more about same sprint automation, so I was hoping that you might be able to walk us through a basic explanation of what same sprint automation means.
Yes, the reason I brought it up is because it came up in quite a lot of discussions that I had with the people here in the conference, a great conference, by the way. I'm happy to hear me here. And it basically means, you know, Scrum. Scrum has sprints, like 2 weeks, 3 weeks, iteration, sometimes 1 week. And one of the holy grails of automated testing is that you get it finished and done in the same sprint as that you develop your system. And so when you asked me for something to talk about, I thought this might be an interesting topic. Because it would be ideal. There are good reasons why you want same sprint automation. At the same time, almost nobody is getting to that point. And why is it important? Because that means that the testers and the automation engineers and the developers and the product owners are all in the same sprint. So as a tester, you find some problem, you can immediately walk over to the developer and the developer can help you. If you have some problems with automation, then you can immediately work with the developers to put maybe some extra tags or labels in their system so that the automation can work. The moment you start losing that battle, if you start to do your automation in the next sprint, and the others are no longer in that same sprint. Yeah. And then that means you're going to be running even later. Mm-hmm. It's like a self-propelling effect.
So, what are the challenges? Because as you mentioned, not a lot of people are there. What are the major challenges in getting your automation into the same sprint automation? What is the biggest kind of hindrance to getting there?
I think there's a couple of reasons that it is difficult. Most of all, the system under test is still under development. Mm-hmm. And you're not running that sprint for nothing. And so there is nothing to test yet. So you have to kind of invent your test cases, build up your test cases, but you cannot actually execute them. And by the time you can execute them, the system might have changed so much, especially the user interface, that they don't work anymore. Mm-hmm. So in a nutshell, that's kind of the problems that you run into.
Right, so if teams are interested in getting there, which I think, to your point, most teams should try to strive for that, what are some steps they can take to try to get same sprint automation, like get to the point where they're doing same sprint automation?
Well, it is difficult, first of all. Find another job or something. No, it is difficult, but I would guess that the two major enablers of automated testing that I'm aware of, apart from good cooperation and all that, but the two main ones are test design and testability. Test design, with that I mean that your tests are organized well, low-level tests do low-level things, high-level tests do high-level things. I can talk about that for a long time. Mm-hmm. But that good test design means your automation is going to be successful. Then the second part is testability. For example, let's say you have a button, and you want to click the button with automation, you need to know where that button is. And in many cases, you're going to do what we call interface mapping. So you can say the caption of the button says OK. And so I'm going to look for a button called OK. But then tomorrow, it might be called submit. And then your test doesn't work anymore. So what a developer can do very easily is put a label in that control that the test tool can see and the user cannot. And when you do that, the chance that you, by the time the sprint goes a little further, the chance that your automation will work increases dramatically. So that are the two major things. Then there are a couple of other conditions. You need to be well prepared. That first of all, that means that as a team, you need to agree on the approach. You need to really agree that we want same sprint automation and it's important. We're even willing to delay our sprint for it. And we really want this. There must be a general commitment, and not just for management or for QA, but from everybody, that it is an important asset to have in your system development. Another thing is, you need to deal with some practical manners before they get into the sprint. An example is data. How do you deal with data? Do you use a production database? Do you create a separate database in a data container or something like that? You need to agree with that. That should not be a point of discussion anymore by the time you get into that sprint. And another thing is technology. Is there any technology that you need to do to maybe test APIs, maybe something with databases, any kind of technology? Because the sprint is not the place to develop new automation technology. So that maybe you need to do a separate sprint only for the automation. There can be all kinds of things you can think of, but you need to do it. And then finally, for this topic, is you need to talk about it. Mm-hmm. What I like to do, I've done that in some projects, is what I call a sit-down meeting. And sprints are well known for the stand-up meeting every morning. What did you do yesterday? What are you going to do today? Are there any impediments? Very useful. Stand up, short. People are full of energy, hopefully, to do the day. At the end of the day, you're kind of tired. You have seen it all. So why did you come to my room? Sit down, have a cup of tea. Not stronger, otherwise you forget. And then you just talk about. You talk about the method. You talk about, okay, I was in the conference that Hans Buwalda was doing a tutorial. And so did that actually work? And what I found is even if you do that a couple of times, the effectiveness of your approach is increasing rapidly. It actually works better than what they call retrospective, and that you do it like a week or more later. And you might already have forgotten important details. So it is more relaxing. You're not talking about the work, you just talk about the method.
Yeah, do you find that sitting down and having those sit-down meetings at the end of the day actually help the next morning when you get into the office prepare for your next day?
Yeah, it could be. And I think it will work for any new approach that you want to introduce. If you want to people to work with AI more or anything else, and then maybe a new tool that you try to apply, maybe some test management that you want to do. Any of these topics, plan it well, talk about it well, have that commitment, make sure that everybody agrees, not just the QA. And it has to do with commitment. A lot of testers, when they talk about how important it is to test, they say, yeah, I was in a conference. In the conference, they said, testing is very important. So the management, can you give me $1 million? I want to do some testing. Won't work. The commitment needs to come from the team, and the commitment needs to come from the business. There must be an understanding that it is good for the business to have good tests, and that it is good for the business to have those tests automated. And then that together leaves you the real drive to actually do it.
So when you do take back some information from this conference, you're like, you know, we should, testing is important, quality is important back to your organization. Yes, you can't just go and ask for $1 million. What are some ways that you can talk to your leadership about and to your team about, hey, this is important, we really have to start, you know, getting good tests written, we need to start having good test automation, and we need to really put a focus on quality. What are some strategies to have those conversations when you come back from a conference like this?
And last, the answer to that question would be, call LogiGear, that's my company, hire me, and I will come and talk to your management. But that's not the right answer. And it's sometimes when people are external, they have more leverage than internal people. That will help. Mm-hmm. But what I would recommend, if you don't want to do that, focus on business. There is a reason that you're testing. You're not testing because you like testing so much. You're testing because somebody in the organization at the business level, executive, commercial people, believe that quality is important, believe that timelines are important, so you need to have effective automation. And the trick is to find out who that is and why that is. And if you get less resources or you get other commitment problems, go back to that issue of, hey, is testing not important anymore? Can that plane go down or whatever? And you need to go back to that business discussion. And you get, and if people say, no, it's really not important, okay, then so be it. I'll go to another conference or do something fun and leave it at that.
Right, and when you do find that person or that group of people that you need to talk to about it, you really want to talk to them in their language they understand, which from a business perspective is often different than a language that...
It could be.
It could be different in terms of trying to get that communication across. So What are some strategies you have employed to try to get the business to understand? Obviously, if they're hiring you, they understand there's some value in quality. But maybe some of the new ideas you're bringing back, you know, if it's around automation or AI or machine learning, how can you help the business better understand the importance of those kinds of things to your test strategy?
Yeah, that's a good question. My focus would be on understanding the business. Mm-hmm. So I wouldn't even talk about testing at all. Mm-hmm. I would just talk about what does this company do or institution, and what makes it successful and what makes it not successful and what do you not want to have in the newspaper. Mm-hmm. And that is, you need to make that translation. I like to call that outside in. So you don't go top down, bottom up, you go outside in. You start with the business. Out of the business comes what kind of testing you need, mm-hmm. what kind of system development you need, whether it makes sense to have Scrum, whether it makes sense to have cycle times of a day or a month or a year, and what works for you. And out of that, the rest of the answers become more easy.
Yeah, and to your point, every situation is different. Every organization, yeah. every business is going to have different needs, yeah. and they're going to be able to figure it out based on their business.
That would also, I think we're running out of time, but mm-hmm. that would also be something that I want to test us to say, be interested in the business. Mm-hmm. And don't just be interested in testing techniques, it's very important, but be interested in the domain that you're testing, the people around, the interest of your test, and work your way from there.
Yeah, absolutely. If testers are asking the business to be interested in testing, it only makes sense for the testers themselves to be interested in the business.
So, absolutely.
Hans, I know it was a quick amount of time here, but I really appreciate you sitting down and talking same sprint automation with me. I love that. And if someone wanted to get in touch with you or learn more about same sprint automation, how might they do that?
LogiGear. Just look us up and look me up. I also have my own website called happytester.com. And the testers need to be happy to be good testers. So you can find me easily. Send me an email and I'll take it from there.
Perfect. Sounds good, Hans. Thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you. Thanks, everybody.